Tuesday to check on the progress of the preparedness of both the entertainment groups, the people who will do the soft side of Jamhuri Day, and also the infrastructure development. We've been here the whole afternoon, and we are very happy that what we committed to have finished by this weekend, the last weekend, has already been done. We've walked, checked the seating arrangements, checked the dais, checked everything that is supposed to be in place by this Sunday. And we are delighted as the National Celebrations Committee to report that we are ready, and what is left now are the small matters of decorations, small matters of rehearsals that we shall continue doing. We'll be here with the technical team first every day. The National Celebration Team in its formation will be here Thursday and Saturday to just ensure that everything is in place. Like I had said last time, we are still having the challenges of COVID, and this field, even though very big, as you will witness when it's opened for you probably by Thursday, we'll only be able to accommodate seating people, public area, 10,000. We'll accommodate 1,000 in the VIP dais, and these have been given through our normal system for distribution. We are using cards for invitation, and the people who are supposed to come have already been informed through their national administrators in the field. We are also here to say that this will be the only celebration in the country. You know, ordinarily we would have all this celebrated from sub-county all the way to the county, but because of those restrictions that we have continued to observe, we agreed that all the other counties will not hold physical celebrations, but will be watching what is happening at Uhuru Gardens on Sunday. So there will only be this celebration, no other. We are happy to report that the other Kenyans who are not able to come here among the 10 will be screening these celebrations live on TVs from 8 a.m. all the way to when it's finished. We'll expect our VIP to arrive by 10:30, and will take about 1.5 hours. So latest 1 p.m. will be finished. We open the gates to the public who are invited at 5 a.m. They will be organized how they come here, and by 8 we expect everyone will be seated waiting for a little entertainment as the VIPs and other dignitaries arrive. Thank you very much. On Saturday, the RC will have a briefing at Hilton, where he will give details about traffic management, which road will be doing what, and how we will move around that time.
Yes, there is some mission.
Yes, I'm being reminded of a very important activity that the Nairobi County Government has offered. From Friday this week at Uchumi, there will be vaccination center set up there, and we have asked that they concentrate as much as possible on the vaccination, that you take only one jab because of the public that will be coming here and probably not have another chance to return. So we are requesting that we exploit this opportunity, to which we run from Friday at 8 a.m., Saturday and Sunday itself, and of course Monday, because it will be a public holiday. We try to capitalize on that opportunity for vaccination. Our security people have assured us that not just around this study, but across the entire Nairobi and indeed the entire country, the security has been beefed up. We know when there's concentration of people, we have to be more careful. we'll have security beefed up. Of course, we also know that this is a flight path. We have layers to the relevant agencies so that within the period of the celebration, we will not have flights around this place. As is the custom, we have a big congregation of people. Don't want that to happen, but that has already been put in place. It will only be for a short time, so the notification has been sent to the airlines. Thank you very much.